practicing. I just want to let you know we're going to get started in about 5 minutes. If you all are standing in the back, if you want to try to see if you can find some seats a little bit further down, there is seating in the balcony, and we'll get started in about 5 minutes. Just wanted you to know. Thanks for being here. Oh, I do also want to say we have found that there are a few names missing from the program, so we will get some programs reprinted to make sure all the names are included of those who registered for the ceremony. So thank you for your patience in that regard. Thanks.
Thank you. Hello, Red Class racers, family, and friends. Welcome to the class of 2026 Sophomore Ring Ceremony. My name is Inshura Kazi, and it's an honor and privilege to serve as the Class of 2026 President. I want everyone here in this auditorium to hold on tight for the ride on which we are about to embark. Let me set a scene for you. Picture this. It's a dark and stormy night. Just kidding. It's actually a beautiful day at Agnes Scott College. And we're gathered here not just for a ceremony, but for a lightning strike of inspiration and celebration. I'm not just class president. Think of me as your Lightning McQueen enthusiast. Ready to rev up the excitement for this unforgettable ring ceremony. Let's go on a drive down memory lane. It felt like only yesterday that we were moving into Walters and Winship. I clearly remember that first week. They were filled with bright, humid, sunny days. And you could always spot us first years wearing our bright red legacy t-shirts. We're now halfway through our time at Agnes Scott College, and these past 2 years have been filled with the most amazing memories. Our first Black Cat Week was a learning curve, for sure. I know we all did not expect Bonfire to be the experience that it was. This year, though, Black Cat Week was different. Our class party was amazing. For those who missed it, you should be devastated. The theme was Midnight in the Garden, and the class party team ate and left no crumbs. As did I, because the food in the dining hall that day hit. It's like they transformed Evans. There was a coffin, there was fog, and the dining hall tables were beautifully decorated. As sophomores entering Black Cat Week, we knew what was expected of us. We had an amazing class secretary and class teams that helped us win second place in the class competitions. Although, in my heart, I believe we won first. Now, let's shift gears and talk about the magic encased in the ring soon to be on your fingers, the Agnes Scott ring. It's not just a piece of jewelry. It's a lightning bolt of connection that transcends time and space. Imagine running into a fellow Scotty at an airport or a restaurant, both of you recognizing the black ring and sparking a conversation that feels like catching up with a long-lost friend. No matter your major or your background, the Agnes Scott experience is the same. We can go on and on talking about Black Cat festivities, staying up until 1 a.m. in McCain libraries, all the weddings in Evans Dining Hall, exploring diverse communities through our journeys trips, and much more. Fasten your seatbelts, because as you walk across the stage today, you're not just crossing a stage. You're zooming into the ranks of generations of Scotties who've done the same. This isn't just a ring. It's an induction into the Black Ring Mafia, a league of extraordinary Scotty alum who've left their mark on this campus and beyond. Now, one of my top five Clifton strengths is futuristic. So with that in mind, let's accelerate into the future. Peak week, where our dreams reach top speeds and our ambitions take the lead. Picture yourself conquering amazing summer internships and jobs, leaving a trail of success that makes Lightning McQueen proud himself. Because, well, we all secretly aspire to be Agnes Scott legends. Duh. As you proudly wear this ring, it's not just a fashion statement. It's a symbol of being part of a powerful Scottyhood. You're not just a student. You're a proud Scotty. And this ring is your badge of honor. It's a symbol of connection that ties us together, a connection that'll keep us grounded and soaring simultaneously. In the immortal words of Lightning McQueen, don't fear failure. Fear not having a chance. So, fellow Scotties, let's rev our engines. Embrace every chance that comes our way. And zoom towards a future filled with success, connection, and the exhilarating spirit of Agnes Scott. I will now introduce you to our guest speaker, Charlene McClure. We came across Charlene's bio as the council was looking for a ring ceremony speaker. And after reading her bio, we knew she could relate to the Red Class of 2026 as a whole. Charlene is a poet, an actor, and a proud 2010 Red Class graduate of Agnes Scott College. Her work has been published in The Offing, Poetry Project, Mosaic, Muzzle, and elsewhere. She received her MA in teaching English as a second language from Hunter College and her MFA in poetry at New York University. She's also been supported by organizations like the Fulbright Program and the Rana Jaffe Foundation. Charlene recently starred in her first A24 film, All Dirt Roads, Taste of Salt. Her journey reminds me that life is a highway, so let's make the best of it. Please join me in welcoming our keynote speaker for this evening, Charlene McClure.
Maybe I shouldn't move it. Hello. Welcome, everyone. I want to first begin by acknowledging all of the friends and families and community members that have gathered with us today to celebrate the class of 2026. Can we give them a please, as they've been yelling and shouting for you, a round of applause? We don't get here alone, right? I also want to thank the officers of your class for inviting me to this to the ceremony to speak with you today as a representative of the Phoenix class of 2020. I'm humbled by the invitation and honored to be here with you today. In the brief time that I have with you, I thought I'd tell you the story of how I lost my ring. I know, hold tight. In 2018, my friend Raven asked to take photos of me at one of the lesser-known parks in Brooklyn. I was surprised by the reeds that outlined the entrance. They reminded me of the summers I spent on the Carolina coast. The city disappeared behind their tall, slender stems as bird calls replaced car horns and sirens. Concrete dissolved to wetlands softened by last night's rain. My feet squished on mud, jostling around in rain boots two sizes too big. But thinking ahead, Raven lent them to me before we left her apartment in Park Slope. We walked until we came to a small clearing. The reeds pointed skyward as golden hour dipped into blue. The moment called for a photo, but we paused, looking at the ground. The mud looked unsettled, like half-baked cake. Was it solid enough to stand on? I was willing to try it out. I took a step, then another, mostly firm. I moved in further, a few paces more, and I could feel my steps starting to sink. I think it's too deep, I told Raven, preparing to turn around. I lowered my right foot to pivot, and the mud swallowed it whole. Ankle deep, I was literally stuck in the mud. I pulled on my leg. It wouldn't budge. I pulled harder, and my foot flew out the boot. The force threw me off balance, and my face was saved by my hand landing in the mud. Raven came in bravely to help. It was a mess, but we got free. We laughed it off by inventing the headlines that would have run if we had died there. But our laughter didn't erase the fear I truly felt in that moment. It lingered unacknowledged, and it must have clouded my thinking, because at the next location, when Raven asked me to take my ring off for a photo, instead of putting it in my pocket or giving it to her to put in her bag, I decided to put it down gently on the same ground that had just tried to swallow me whole. It was shiny gold. It would be seen clearly, right? We searched and searched and searched. It was gone. The land wanted a sacrifice. Better the ring than our lives, I told Raven. Life is more precious than gold. But inwardly, oh, I was crestfallen. Beyond its simple elegance and beauty, my ring was a reminder to be true to the commitments I made while at Agnes. To think deeply, to live honorably, to engage challenge. When I gazed at my ring, I recalled the strides I'd made on campus, on study abroad, and in the world after graduation. A Fulbright scholar, a published poet, a public school teacher. Who would I be without it? A phoenix is distinguished by its fiery deaths. Feathers, skin, and bone incinerate in flames. Yet the essence of the phoenix is never touched. It flies off in a coat of ashes. 3 years later, Raven and I returned to the park. A week before, on Raven's invitation, I submitted a self-tape to audition for one of the characters in her first feature film, All Dirt Roads Taste of Salt. She asked me to the park so we could talk more about the role. We sat on a blanket along the creek's edge on a calm, sunny day as I listened to her share the details a few feet away from where my ring was last seen. Who would I be without it? A circle has no clear beginning or ending. It's endless, and in that endlessness, it keeps fidelity with itself. This is integrity. As you wear your rings, may you connect to this quality of being. Your sensitivity, Your vulnerability are the means by which you gather information to think deeply. Your innate intelligence, exercised but not measured by essays and exams. Divine intelligence, indigenous to each child that pushed themselves out of the birth canal, flexing their heads during the late stages of labor, nestling down through the hips to participate in their own birth. Intelligence that heals cuts to scabs and new skin. This intelligence bestows you your dignity and mandates the compassion that is necessary to live honorably in this wondrous, mysterious, traumatized world we share. What do you see in this world? What stirs in you when you look and listen? Pay close attention. That which stirs within you is your fire. Your visions of the world are illuminated by it, your inner pyre. Does it dwindle in fear or anxiety at the devastation that it sees? Is it depressed, almost blown out by the daily, gratuitous violence? Does it burn in rage at the sight of cruelty? Is it set ablaze by injustice? Does it smolder in grief and sorrow? Or is it moved by a hand on the shoulder, by someone you love holding you, by anonymous people doing the thankless work for justice, by generations and generations of determination and love, by the mystery and the miracle of the stardust that is in your bones, by the dazzling colors of the setting sun that will rise with the birds in the morning. To burn is to live, my friends. To live attuned to the intensity and the subtlety of how we feel is how we come to any understanding, individual or collective. At least, this is true for me. I believe this is how we learn. Learning not a one-time academic achievement, not a spectacle made out of knowledge to inflame an ego, not validated by grades or degrees. True learning awakens the heart. It lives in the unknown like the shadows around a flame. It is endless as the galaxies beyond human reach, and just as timeless, blurring the lines of the past and future in each newly born present moment. Attuned to fire, your fire, attentive and curious, we can engage challenges that arise from the shadows. Grounded in insight and clarity, we can act as the moment calls for us to act, with creativity in play, in policy, and in protest. This ring is an invitation. It invites you to acknowledge and tend to your fire, to rev your engines. May you align with it. May you be guided by your integrity, which this ring symbolizes, but does not endow. But you know, try to hold on to it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Charlene, for your words.
And now we will begin the ring ceremony. Scotties, please rise when your usher instructs your row to do so. You can sit down when you return to your seats. We will begin with the members of the platform party who will be receiving their rings. Trinity Baggett. Inshira Kazi.
Alexa Robinson. Lindy Hollowfield. Amila Nadim. Annabelle McGee. Isabel Adams. Sarah Engstap. Anika Anika. Mekdez Anili. Kathy Arojo Hernandez. Teresa Maria Ariza. Elliot Arp. Rachel Arwood. Shay Aitkins. Ryan Barber. Sophia Barrett. Marilyn Bates. Linda Lizeth Bautista Tellez. Lizzie Beal. Kinsey Baudois. Gia Binton. Ava Byerly. Sophie Bollard. Jalen Bolden. Lily Brickmeyer. Sarai Briganti. Corey Britton. Alicia Brown. Anika Buck. Salem Burdett. Parker Carter. Jennifer Castellanos. Caitlin Cheney. King Lin Chin. New Haman Chernette. Kay Christofferson. Mia Sisweski. Madison Kopedge. Kira Cousin. Catherine Cox. Kennedy Culver. Jelani Daniel. Anjali Immaculate David. Annalise Dimblaker. Atia Duncan. Sophia Edelman. Kai Edom. Brianna Edmond. Belle Ewing. Olive Fallen. Nora Fairbanks. Sabra Fitzgerald. Catherine Fitzgibbon. Cammy Flaherty. Orisha Flores. Zoe Flowers. Adriana Foster. Ansley Franklin. Danila Garcia Laura. Lil Gaynor. Jalen Gonzalez. Zoe Good. Chandler Grant. Cameron Greer. Morgan Hackbarth. Max Hale. Lucy Hall. Doreen Harimana. Aurora Harkins. Rebecca Harshman. Zoe Heath. Lex Highleg. Nina Henderson. Rachel Hill. Anna Hillesim. Malaysia Hodge. Madeline Hoffman. Samantha Canella. Marion Holt. Camilla Hope. Kira Hornsby. Charity Horton. Audrey Hudson. Charlie Hughes. Isabella Honor. Madison Jackson. Annie Jacobs. Yashi Jadhav. Ryan Jenkins. Hallie Johnson. Bryn Johnson. Alina Johnson. Ty Johnson. Katie Jones. Kyla Kellum. Paige Kelly. Danny Kahn. Linan Koh. Eliza Kroll. Tara Kurian. Hannah Lang. Victoria Rose Langley. Mercury Lapham. Mai Lei. Kiki Limke. Isabella Leonardi. Claire Lewis. Isabel Lay. Naomi Lippitt. Macklin Lyle. Beck Littlehale. Indy Patel Lorick. Marles Lloyd. Bria Mabry. Emma Magnus. Corbin Mahari. Cece Mahan. Kamaya Mays. Ireland McCage. Mia McCown. Noe McCurley. Ambry McElmore. Lila McMaster. Amani Milligan. Brianne Mitchell. Erica Michelle Washington. Leah Mokri. Lily Moon. Bethany Moore. Raylan Mornay. Siobhan Morris. Anye Mouchette. Genesis Narcisse. Julia Norcross. Julia O'Brien. Genji O'Brien. Tayema O'Perry. Sarah Osula. Evelyn Patricio. Jordan Peoples. Reagan Pierre. Jessica Pinsker. Catherine Pittman. Hannah Porch. Selena Pruitt. Zoe Price. Francis Pujay. Mari Radtica. Iris Ray. Anna Jeanette Resendez Zavila. Casey Rice. Tiana Richards. Ansley Rickson. Elena Riley. Jordan Robinson. Adelaide Robinson. Anderson Rodriguez. Lou Roldan. Jalen Romans. Rowan Rosenberg. Emma Rosenberger. M. Roland. Virginia MacArthur. Kimberly Santabria. Melissa Sanchez. Tavi Schoolfield. Jordan Schrage. Fatima Sidime. Piper Smith. Emma Ann Stevens. Adriana Stewart. Brandy Stewart. Tallulah Stroud. Yasmin Swastige Peru Lero. Anya Talbot. Naomi Tefera. Jennifer Thames. Sophia Tovar. Zaina Towns. Soraya Turner. Gianna Urego. Annie Vanderhyde. Blake Vance. Lacia Weekland. Morgan Wellman. Chai Wheeler. Anna Whittemer. Lila Williams. Olivia Yanez. Wongolowit Zerga. Yuen Shin Zhou. Jassy Bell. Maggie Wade. Madison Porcina.
Congratulations, Red Class, on receiving your rings. I would now like to welcome to the stage President of my Alumni Board, Ellen Parker Gaffney, Class of 1987.
Greetings, Class of 2026. On behalf of the Agnes Scott Alumni Association and the thousands of Scotties all over the world who are at this very moment wearing their black onyx rings, congratulations. And welcome to the club. It is an honor to be here to celebrate this milestone with you. When I received my ring as a sophomore back in 1985, this ceremony did not yet exist. We picked up our rings in the alumni gardens. It was kind of a drop-in, casual event, nothing like this lovely occasion. I still have my box, though, and there's a little sticker on it that says I owed $113, which I paid before leaving the alumni gardens with this fantastic piece of statement jewelry. Something I wear every single day. Because I wear my ring all the time, my adult daughter painted a small sign for me, and it sits on my dresser. It says, "You're never fully dressed without an onyx." I think you will be surprised by how many comments you receive while wearing it when you aren't on campus, and how many alumni you will connect with because they recognize this symbol of Scottyhood. This fall, I was driving down Atlanta Road in my car, and I wasn't sure if I was experiencing road rage by the person in the SUV next to me, but she was wildly waving her hand. She was a Scotty. She was so excited because I have an Agnes Scott tag on my car. I was excited to learn that your class mascot is Lightning McQueen. I'm a huge Disney fan, some might say fanatic. And there is something wonderful about your class choosing a confident and ambitious, shiny red race car as its mascot. I can personally identify with his motivational quote, "I am faster than fast, quicker than quick, I am lightning." But like all of us, Lightning has to learn some hard lessons along the way. Lessons about what really matters, patience, humility, and finding community. Social interaction is something many of us took for granted prior to March of 2020, but even introverts like myself have to admit that we all need community. We need support and interaction. So I encourage you to continue to form bonds with one another as a class, because these friendships will be with you your entire lives. We all need meaningful relationships in life, and those forged at Agnes Scott are among the most meaningful. I am still very close with my Scotty siblings from the 1980s, but I am also fortunate to have met some amazing Scotties from other decades. We have met through seminars and travel and through my work with the alumni board. I appreciate the ability to lean on and learn from my fellow alums in the vast alumni network. Continue to nurture your friendship groups while you are here, but I also want to encourage you to take the chance to be a part of something bigger. Your college needs you, and believe it or not, you may find that you need it too. So if you have not already done so, I invite you to place your Agnes Scott ring on your finger, with the ASC letters on your ring turning towards you. As you continue your journey of learning and leadership development at Agnes Scott. I can hear all those boxes. I know. Y'all were so very patient to wait to put them on. I'm very impressed. And once you have your ring on with the letters facing you, put up your hands, show off your rings. This is your visible sign that you are now officially part of the Scotty family. I encourage you to wear your rings with pride and with the responsibility that comes with being a Scotty, to think deeply, to live honorably, and to engage the social and intellectual challenges of our times. In a couple of years, you will cross the stage at commencement, and you will be asked to turn your ring around so that the ASC letters face out for all the world to see, and you begin your journey as Agnes Scott alumni. Congratulations again, class of 2026. And now I would like to welcome members of the Agnes Scott Sotto Voce as they lead the college hymn. Please stand if you are able and join us in singing God of the Marching Centuries.
Thank you, Sotto Voce. Audience, you may be seated if you haven't done so. Wow, what an amazing time to be a Scotty right now, am I right? I'm Lindy Hollifield, class of 2026 secretary and black cat chair. I must say, standing up here in front of this many people and delivering a speech as this is a much easier task than coordinating Black Cat Week. With all jokes aside, today I serve a greater purpose, as I am honored to be introducing our illustrious college president, Leocadia I. Zack. President Zack is the 9th president of Agnes Scott and has developed significant success in innovation, teaching, first-year experience in social mobility. Under her leadership, Agnes Scott will continue to thrive through the next formative years with transformative education, ensuring student success, building a culture of community, and engaging the world beyond the campus. Thanks to her innovation, we will see many more receive this opportunity that we are all here for today. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to President Zach.
Thank you very much, Lindy, for that gracious introduction. Family and friends, what a phenomenal occasion. I'm delighted to welcome you all to campus for this very important event. I have to say, this is one of the most special times of year on our campus. This is an amazing moment for our Scotties. And I'm so glad that you were able to join us and be part of it. Class of 2026, today marks a significant milestone in your journey at Agnes Scott. As many have mentioned, just a year and a half ago, you joined us. And since then, you've made friends, discovered new paths, had many experiences. Today, with this ceremony, you are part of a strong, smart, innovative, thoughtful, and honorable community of Scotties who wear the ring proudly. Family and friends, you may not understand the significance of this special Agnes Scott rite of passage, although we've heard many wonderful stories. The onyx ring is a symbol that incorporates our proud traditions, and it is the most single, recognizable image of the college. This ring, as was previously mentioned, is more than a piece of jewelry. It is a symbol of unity. It is a conversation starter when Scotties meet each other as they're leading around the world. You heard many of the stories today, and there are many, many more of Scotties meeting, gathering, uniting, telling stories, all by being introduced by this ring. In addition to the stories you've heard, I'd like to add one more story. And many of you hear me say how proud I am of our Agnes Scott students. They amaze me every day with what they can do, what they will do, who they are, how amazing they are. And a few years ago, when we had this ceremony, some of the students realized that not everybody was at the ceremony. Not everybody crossed the stage. And they wondered why. And one of the reasons why was that not everyone could afford a ring. So one of the hallmarks of Agnes Scott is not only are our Scotties looking out for one another, but they also take action. So our Student Government Association got together and thought about what is it that they could do. And what they decided to do is to ensure that every student could get a ring. So they asked whether or not it could be incorporated into the student fees, and the answer was yes. So today, every single sophomore can receive a ring and cross the stage because of the amazing thoughtfulness, kindness, and action by fellow Scotties. And that's who our students are. Those are the students that we see every day. They're the students that grow into the amazing alumni that we've heard today as well. So I am so proud of them. I'm so proud of what it is that they accomplish while they're here on campus, but I'm equally proud of what I know that they're going to accomplish when they leave here as well. Class of 2026, I hope that this ring serves as a reminder to you of what you do on our campus every day, how you interact with your peers, how much you mean to the faculty, staff, and administration, that you right now have already left a legacy, but you're going to continue to while you're here, and that this ring unites all of us on our campus and unites all of our Scotties. I am so happy to be with you all today. I'm so happy to look out and see so many people who came to celebrate this very special day. Congratulations to all of our amazing Scotties, the class of 2026. Can we give them a round of applause? And now I'd like to welcome Alexa Robinson to the podium for closing remarks. Alexa?
Thank you, President Zach, Ellen Parker Gaffney, and Charlene McClure for your thoughtful and encouraging words. Thank you to the class council for all your hard work and previous members, Jane McClelland and A. Chan Mo. Red class, welcome to the Black Ring Mafia. Looking out into this crowd as your vice president, I can't help but feel an immense amount of pride and gratitude. Despite our hardships, struggles, and trials, we've made it to the halfway mark. And though at times it may be hard to see, every day you are stepping further into your Agnes Scott legacy. I see each and every one of you leading as catalysts of change in our world. And as you accept this ring, you make a promise to yourself and every Scotty that comes after. You promise to think deeply, live honorably, and I don't think I've come across anyone who engages with the challenges of our times more than you do. You promise to be yourself and speak your mind, even when you fear no one is listening. Someone is listening. We're all listening. Let this ring be a beacon of hope in your darkest hours. Let this ring be a sign that your journey hasn't ended, it has only just begun. I hope you take this symbol, take your pride, take your legacy, and run with it. Please wait until all members of the class of 2026 have left the auditorium, and then you are all welcome to join us in Evans Dining Hall for a light reception immediately following the recessional. Thank you and congratulations again.
Garden gate, there's not much time left today.